YouTubers, what's up? Mr. Chris the Trucker here, and giving you another update on my truck driving job finding, and have not found one still. I have been out of truck driving since March of this year. My last company was Covenant. Got two minor backing accidents with Covenant due to my co-driver I had. He told me every time I try to get out and do my goal, which is get out and look, he kept telling me, get back in, I won't let you hit nothing. But as soon as I get back in, start backing, and I hit something. So, gee, guess what? They had put me on 180-day probation, which is 6 months. And I was able to still drive and everything, but when they put me on that probation, it was time for my home time. So I came home and was going to go ahead and go back out within 4 or 5 days. But talked to my wife. She needed me here because she got high blood pressure. So I had to help get that under control, which it is now. And it's been doing good for 6 months now. So, and while I've been doing that, I've been looking for another company to get on to. And nobody would take me because I got 3 accidents total. The first one was Swift, because I was making the right turn. I thought I made it wide enough, and I didn't. I took down a street sign, carried a boulder a quarter of a mile. So, oh well. But you know, what can you do? Hey. But they're all preventable accidents, of course, and but they're not recorded on my DMV record. So anyway, still looking for a job. Nobody wants to take me because of the accidents. The first one was in 2010. The last two, of course, was 2011. So I'm still looking. Most of the companies I went to, they told me, like U.S. Express, we're not hiring in that area. I live in Redding, California, and I guess the northern part of California, they don't hire. So all the way up to, I guess, Portland, they don't hire. So if I was in Sacramento, which is 150 miles from me, yeah, they'd hire me. But again, if I was in Sacramento, told them about the accidents, they wouldn't hire me because it's over their threshold. So, or within their threshold. But you can't do it. So, anyway, still looking. And will continue to look. Now, I was told to wait 3 years because that's how long it takes for all that to drop off. If I wait 2 years, the first one will drop off. So, if I wait any length of time, hey guys, what happens? I gotta go through a refresher course if I do that. And really don't want to do that because, one, I don't have the money. Two, if I go with a company that decides to take me and they say, okay, you gotta do a refresher course with us, and then they take that amount out of my check. Well, I got a family to feed. You know, I got a wife and kid. So I can't afford that. So what I have to do right now, I guess, is just wait and hope that I get one before the time comes to where everybody's saying, you need a refresher course and all this. So, you know, in my eyes, if I have the money, and I can wait. I say, yeah, sure, no problem. I'll do the refresher course because, you know, I wouldn't mind taking one. I mean, everybody can use a refresher course. You know, I'll sit and wait and see what happens. But if nothing happens within a couple months here, 2 or 3 months, then I'm going to have to continue on my other avenue, which is real estate, which really isn't a good thing to get into right now. But, you know, at least it'd be some kind of money coming in. So, I also got my computer skills I can fall back on. You know, I just right now don't know what to do. But anyway, you know, new people that are getting out there, want to get out there and do truck driving, I encourage it. But don't switch, don't bounce from company to company to company to company because it don't look good in your record. And I'd say maybe two or three companies at the most, you know, at least two at the most. Find which one you want. Yeah, and before you get into that company, check them out. You know, you might hear a bunch of bad things about them. Like Swift, I heard a bunch of bad things about them, but I went with them anyway. They were actually pretty good, but their equipment was just crap. And they supposedly got some new equipment now, so I don't know. But they're all are going. Swift is all switching their trucks over to electronic logs. Same with the Covenant. They were in the process of doing that. They were supposed to have done our truck when I was on it. And they just kept putting it off. So, and then that was another reason why I left too, is because Covenant would say one thing and do another. But all in all, Covenant, I can't put them down really because they did make me some money. So they did run me, and they will run you hard. Swift, same thing. They'll run you hard too. I just like to go teams, but I'm kind of shy with Covenant and teams because most of their teams are in the LA area because that's where two of their terminals are at is over there in the LA area, Ontario and Pomona. So anyway, gotta go, guys. Got things to do. Got, you know, some research to do. So just wanted to give you a quick update of what's going on. And that's it. Still unemployed. Still getting turned down by every trucking company there is. Conway told me they might hire me if I wait till next year. Which it looks like that's all I'll be doing is waiting till next year. And see what they do. If they hire me, sweet. Because Conway, I'd really want to get on with Conway because I heard a lot of good things about Conway. And they got a good package, too. So, anyway, guys, have fun. When, those of you that are driving truck right now, be safe. Keep the shiny side up, dirty side down. Talk with you later.